gathered here today to celebrate a day of gratitude, gladness, and joy. It's one of life's greatest miracles when two people love each other so much that they are willing to commit their lives together as one in spirit. You got what I want. You got what I need. Got me dreaming of you. I don't know what to do. Mercy, mercy me. You got me wrapped up. You really got a hold on me. You got me so stuck. You got me. You're all that I want.
Mimi, no, you're my heart, my soul, my joy. I love you so. And I'm sure that so many people around here feel the same way. You've enriched the lives of so many folks. You've made my life so much better, for sure. Being you, you remind me of Grandma Shirley, my mom, Des, and sometimes even me. But there's so much that's just you. It makes you so very special.
Oh, you got what I need. I can't help but want more.
Jeff, there are so many wonderful things about you. If I started talking about them, I think you'd probably miss your flight tomorrow. So the thing I love most about you, I think, is you're such a mensch. You're a man of such integrity and honor, and you love the people close to you so much, and I know you'd do anything for them. So God bless you for that.
The ability to love is a miraculous gift which God has given us, and a wedding is a celebration of that gift. Today we've been invited to share and to rejoice with Miriam and Jeff, and to vow our unconditional love and a support to them as they begin their journey as husband and wife.
Jeff, you're my best friend, my better half, my soulmate. With you, I'm living my real life fairy tale. You make me feel special every single day.
Mimi, I remember the first time I realized I love you. The words came out of my mouth a long time before my mind was ready to acknowledge it. But in my heart, from that first moment, I never stopped loving you.
You make me better. You believe in me when I don't believe in myself. Though it wasn't a straight and narrow journey to get to you, I travel that road over and over again if I knew it meant to you.
People often wonder what love is, how to describe it. To me, it's a feeling that very few people can articulate. I've always summed it up since I met Mimi with one word: home.
You have filled my life with so much love and laughter. I vow to do my best. I vow to give you all of me. I vow to love you unconditionally. It's me and you, babe, until the end of time.
Now that we're here, now that we're human, we run through a city, city of light. Our hands in the air when we're doing nothing. It's everything, and we fall in love. And we're
we have created a bond unlike any other. I have tried to come up with the perfect speech, but after countless drafts, I realized that there's nothing I can say that would come close to describing you as a person and our relationship as a whole. The only thing that I could say is this: Dad, I may be your best man, but that pales in comparison to the friend, role model, teacher, and father you've been for me. Thank you for the honor, Dad. I love you.
Playing a role in this special day for these two very special people is easily one of my greatest honors in life to date. Your relationship is thoughtful and patient and, most importantly, unconditional. Thank you for loving her the way that you do. And Mimi, thank you for the gift of Jeff. I think I speak for everyone when I say that to know him is to love him. You guys have the unique gift of knowing that the best is yet to come. I love you guys, and cheers.
It's never